In this video, I'm going to simplify CFTRI MSc Entrance Exam 2019 preparation tips that have been given by Sanjeev Kumar Sharma sir. This is the part 2 of the CFTRI Entrance Exam video series. If you have not watched the part 1, I would highly recommend that please go and watch that video. I will link that video somewhere in the description. Assuming that you have watched the part 1, let us move on. I have been getting a few comments in my YouTube videos to explain about the preparation tip of the CFTRI MSc entrance exam. What are the strategies and how do we approach it? What I can do about after BSc or what I can do after BTech? A lot of you have been commenting in my videos and also in my Instagram. Oh, by the way, we are on Instagram. Don't forget to follow me there. On my Instagram, I'm also getting some messages that could you please make a video on CFTRI MSc entrance exam? We need to prepare for that. We need to know what are the strategies. And I thought, all right, if I'm going to give you some preparation strategies, some tips for the MSc entrance exam, then why not get them from one of the experts, one of the guru of the food tech entrance exam in India? If you have not guessed already, I'm talking about Sanjeev Kumar Sharma sir, who has written a book, Objective Food Science, and that is followed all over the India for the students who are preparing for the ICAR NET exam, who are preparing for the GATE exam, who are preparing for CFTRI MSc entrance exam. He has given guidance to hundreds and thousands of students all over the India about the entrance exams, how to crack the entrance exams. And I contacted him and I'm really grateful that he agreed to help me and to help you, to guide you and to give you the preparation steps and the strategies to crack the CFTRI MSc entrance exam. So in this video, I'm going to simplify CFTRI MSc entrance exam preparation tips and strategies. And please remember that I'm acting as a medium. This video is acting as a medium between sir and you so that you can understand what are the preparation tips and how do you approach for the exam. So there are total 11 subjects. There's physics, chemistry, mathematics, biology, microbiology, biochemistry and nutrition, agriculture and dairy technology, engineering, food technology, my favorite, horticulture and home science. If you want to know the syllabus of the MSc entrance exam, then I will put a link down in the description so that you can check for yourself that what is the syllabus and what are the topics that you have to study. The question paper will have objective type questions, and just in case you are stressing over the fact that there are multiple subjects and you have expertise in just one or two subjects, then relax, take a deep breath. CFTRI has clearly mentioned that there will be balanced distribution of questions from each of the subjects so that students from various eligible streams will get equal opportunity to score in the test. Now, the number one thing that you need to remember is that they ask fundamental questions. There is no need to go in extreme depth. You can understand the basic concepts and you can score well in the exam. The second tip is that you have to revise the subjects that you already know. Strengthen these subjects and don't try to cover all the subjects. Don't try to master all the subjects. A lot of students make this mistake that they try to master all the subjects. They try to cover all the subjects. And that is why most of them fail. If you are really serious about this exam, then keep in mind that please revise those subjects that you already know. Strengthen those subjects that you already know. Try to master all the subjects. That will lead you nowhere. So try to focus on one or two things at a time. And when you have truly revised, and when you have completely revised that subject, when you have completely mastered that subject, then you can move on to the next one because the time is very limited. You have to utilize the time very efficiently. By the way, are you taking notes? Am I stupid? Please take notes. These are very important tips. The third tip is to study the past year papers. Now, a lot of students, they do study the past year papers, but they don't study the past year papers the way they should. A lot of them rote memorize all the objective type questions. They try to cram, they try to pattern. And what is that term? They try the rectification. They try to rote memorize all the objective type questions, and the objective food science book is not developed in such a way that you rote memorize all the objective type questions. That is a very wrong approach. What you need to do, you need to analyze that, okay, if this question is coming repeatedly, if this topic is arising repeatedly in the past year papers, that means it can also appear in the next exam. You have to analyze the paper. It is not just for rote memorization. It is for analysis. It is for getting an idea. Okay, this question has not appeared too many times so that I can leave that topic. But if this topic has appeared a lot of times, then I should definitely cover this topic. So keep that in mind. Analysis can change your game. If you want to practice objective type questions, you can do that from Objective Food Science that is written by Sanjeev Sir. I will put a link down in the description for that book so that you can purchase it from Amazon. And for some reason, if you cannot buy it, then please download the Manyaversity app, the Manya Quiz app, and that is available for the Android smartphone. So that has about 2,000 questions for you to practice, and the app has separate sections for horticulture, for dairy technology, for food technology. By the way, you can play food technology and try to beat me. Don't try that. The fourth tip is to attempt the questions that you are confident about. And this, you may have heard about this a lot of times, that okay, just attempt the questions that you already know. But this also has a psychological effect on the mind. If you start to attempt the questions that you already know, you start to gain confidence and you can perform better in the exam. And there's good news for you, that there is no negative marking. So what you can do, you can just attempt all the questions that you already know, that you are confident about, and later attempt those that you are not confident about, and don't leave any marks, don't leave anything, because there is no negative marking. The fifth tip is, don't bother about your graduation marks. In the last video, I told that 50% weightage is given to your college exams, to your college degree, and 50% weightage is given to your entrance exam, the marks that you are going to secure in the entrance exam. Now, a lot of students stress over the fact that they had got less marks in their college, in their graduation. So don't worry if you are stressing over the fact, you still have hope. This entrance exam is your second chance. Let me demonstrate using some simple calculations. Let us assume that there are two candidates. There is candidate Karan and there is candidate Ravi. Now, candidate Karan got 90% in his graduation, whereas candidate Ravi got 84% in his graduation. But 50% of the graduation marks are considered, so let us divide these by 2. Now, 90% divided by 2 is 45%, whereas 84% divided by 2 is 42%. Now, if you look closely, there is the difference of 3% between 45 and 42%. That means Ravi, who got 84%, doesn't need to lose hope. He just needs to do 3% more than Karan in the exam. That means he just needs to do 6 correct questions, 6 more correct questions on the same level as that of Karan. I'm very poor at math, so if you didn't understood that what was the calculation all about, you can comment down below if you have any doubts. Now, another important thing here is that CFTRI do not release their past year papers, their question papers. So if you are watching this video right now, and if you are going for this exam in CFTRI, then please remember, then right after coming from the exam, please note down the questions, note down the topics that you understood. You don't need to write down all the questions, just the questions that you remember, and send that to foodtechsimplified@gmail.com. Or if you cannot mail them, if you are really stressed about writing a mail, don't worry about that. You can also direct message me on foodtech_simplified in Instagram. And why is that? Because we need objective, because the Objective Food Science book by Sanjeev Sharma sir would not have been possible without the efforts of the people, of the efforts of the candidates that have contributed the questions. Because CFTRI does not release the questions, but the next generation, the people who are going to appear in the 2020, 2021, in the 2022 and upcoming years, they are going to need the past year papers. And that will not be possible if people like you do not contribute. So I would highly request that please contribute the question papers, the questions of the question papers, basically. And you can do that by Instagram. You can do that by mailing me. And just remember, you don't need to remember all the questions. You just need to remember certain topics. If you cannot remember the whole question, the whole MCQ, that is completely fine. But please do contribute. It's a kind request to you. Once again, I'm very grateful and very thankful to Sanjeev sir for helping me out and for helping you out in the preparation and the strategy for this exam. Give this video a thumbs up and comment down below if you have any kind of doubts or any kind of queries. I will make sure that I reply to each one of you, and do subscribe if you have not already. I'll see you next time.